This next tune is entitled After Forever. Okay, never heard this tune before in my life. I'm looking forward to getting stuck in. Dez at King of the Pit TV, Black Sabbath, Master of Reality, the full album, at Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Let's get stuck in, people. Come on. Might have a little sip of my water. Aqua Roma still flavoured. Sounds like I'm being abducted by aliens, this intro. Come on. Quite an upbeat number. Yo, they've upgraded the riff game since the self-titled, I'm not gonna lie. Yo, this record is good. This record, two tunes, it's good. This riff sounds like a daytime television program intro. If you're outside of England, I don't think you'll know what a soap is, but it's like a television drama that airs during the daytime, okay? And this is a textbook intro for one of them programs. And if you're not from England, yeah, and you want a bit of entertainment, search Jeremy Kyle on YouTube, yeah? Trust me, Jeremy Kyle, see the best of Britain on there. Get your cowboy boots on, we're off for a line dance, people. Oh, have you heard how heavy that bass guitar just got then? Some aggressive twang on that. Ozzy's basically rapping at this point. Not really any commentation at this point, as we've just sort of been cycling around the same riffs. Not gonna lie, this riff in particular to me has gotten a little bit old at this point, a little bit stale, alright. Now, I can't fault Sabbath, yeah, but when you take, listen to radio pop songs, yeah, or like pop structured songwriting in general, and you'll see that the sections will go, you know, brief introduction, maybe about 4 or 8 bars. Then you've got the then you got the verse, right? Which I would call this a verse section. So you got the idea, the verse, yeah, with the vocal melody and the rhythm on the instrumentals, you know, or the riff of the instrumental. From there, you might have a pre-chorus, if not just straight into the chorus. From there, you'll also have an intro, so to speak, but we call it a turnaround section, okay? Just 4 bars after the chorus before going back into the verse, right? So you've got 2 verses now, yeah? Then you have maybe a pre-chorus into the chorus once again. So you've now had 2 pre-choruses and 2 chorus sections, okay? As well as 2 verses. Now, after the chorus, you don't go into another verse. You do what's called a bridge section, all right? And the idea of the bridge section is to completely just throw a different element in there, switch it up completely, a different idea, perhaps a change of key, perhaps a change of tempo, and then you finish off on a third chorus, all right? Now, the idea of going into that bridge is that you want to break that pattern of three with the verse, okay? Because not only will it get boring, the idea of 3 choruses is that's the hook, and that's what you're going to be using to really dial in the memory of your audience, given that you do a good job. You want it to be catchy and memorable, and of course we all know about earworms and how when something's repetitive enough, it just gets stuck in our head, whether we like it or not, all right? That's the idea of having 3 in a row with the chorus. But when it comes to the verse, yeah, you only want it twice around, and that, psychologically speaking, right, we think, all right, we've heard 2, so we're going to be awaiting a third, all right? We're going to be awaiting a pattern to emerge. So when you take that third out and replace it with something completely different, it becomes so new and it wakes us back up and suddenly we're paying attention to the song again. But if we go into a third verse, it's going to bore us. We've heard it all before. What's new? Okay, even if it's a 3-minute song, we need to know what's new, all right? So this, as of so far, if we were to say, oh, pop songwriting and all, oh, but it's not Taylor Swift and that, I understand it's not the greatest sort of application, but long story short, I'm kind of bored of this riff right now because I wish they would have done something different and verged into something else, all right? I've heard this idea 3 times over now. Quite a proggy section. I was gonna say, and I'm low-key hoping there's not a guitar solo in every single one of these tracks. See, all of this bit, I'm going to be honest with you, just seems like really fluffy to me. I know I don't want to talk down on the godfathers of what we know of most guitar music, but I don't need to hear these 2 riffs anymore. The television program intro and this riff, I don't want to hear it anymore. I would have just cut the end of this song off and moved on to the next one, get some new ideas flowing. Which, if you're a musician, I guess it goes to show you don't have to be amazing and appeal to everyone, because this tune doesn't appeal to me. It did initially, but at this point, I think I don't want to listen to this again. It just drags on for me. And Black Sabbath are Black Sabbath, of course. So if you're in a band, do your best effort. You don't have to aim for being, you know what I mean, the most technically viable and perfect act. You just need to keep the movements going, be in the right place at the right time, obviously, and go out and network and do your thing, and you might end up like this band. Good background music, this too. Cool, I think we got like a bridging section coming up entitled Embryo, judging by the length of it. Them guitars are out of tune. Sounds like some very old traditional music. That high register, them that string or two is out of key, but it doesn't matter. I'm not judging it. I'm just making a statement. Cool. Right, and that was that tune. That was entitled After Forever. It was all right. As I said, it wasn't my favourite tune I've heard so far. When we kicked into it, I thought, yes, we're getting onto something here, because after listening to the self-titled record, I thought a lot of it was just a bit too jammy. It seemed as if they had a few good ideas and then just filled the gaps with like just extended like solo sections, which didn't please me, to be honest. It would have if I was younger, but now I just want to hear substance, and if it doesn't need to be there, I don't like to hear it. So, you know, to me, going through them two riffs, them reoccurring riffs, I think it was drilled a little bit too much. Wasn't too fussed about that, but it was good, obviously. I don't mind. I think the production's good. I think the vocal line is good, and so far so good. So that's it. We're going to move on to the next track. If you want me to, you know, check out anything in particular, leave a comment down below, people.